right now, I'm going to show you a feature that you are going to absolutely love. It saves so much time when working with type. It's dynamic text. No, it's probably not what you think it is. It's something actually really beautiful and exciting. Let's have a look. So right now, I want to show you something new and amazing with text. There's a couple of things, but one of the things we're going to be doing here is only in Photoshop Beta. So in order to get that, you're going to click on Creative Cloud. Then you're going to choose Apps. At the top, you'll see Beta. And then download the Photoshop Beta. Now, on many computers, you can run both the beta and the regular version at the same time. All right, so let's have a look at what I want to show you right now. So I'm going to grab the type tool. And if I click, I can do just regular text, but if I drag, I can create a paragraph box. Right, and I've just pasted in some text here. So here's the first thing. Adobe Fonts now has 1,500 new fonts, includes Helvetica, Gotham, Avenir, Times New Roman, Arial, and then Proxima Nova is now in 4 more languages. Okay, I'm just going to apply this type, and notice you can just kind of move this around. But if you look over here on the left, notice I've been kind of stacking the type to make it look more interesting. This is the amazing new feature. It is called Dynamic Text. So with the text tool selected and a block of text there, we're just clicking it, so we're selecting it. You'll see this lightning bolt. Click on this, and it will change it so it will flow. As I change this text box, notice what we can do now is it will create these beautiful blocks of formatted type. Now, if I want to, you know, put some of these on their own line, I'm just going to put the carriage return here, and then we just do art, and let's go right at the end here, and we'll do art of typography, and notice that goes in there. I'm just going to hit Control A, and let's change this to a bold font instead. And I'm just going to reduce this down a little bit just to make it a little bit more interesting. Now notice, as I change this text box, I change the shape of it. And as I drag, notice this will just dynamically change. But also notice where I put the carriage returns here, those are going to stay on their own line no matter what shape I do. Now, if I wanted to just select these, I could change the color of this particular one. So notice that we have the ability to do that. Now, what I can't do is resize it, because if I go in here and I try to resize it, it's not going to change. And that's because the size is dynamic. It's not a fixed size. It's going to be determined by the shape of this box. Now, if we want to change things like the spacing in between and different things like that, what we want to do is go under the Properties panel here, and then you're going to scroll down, making sure, of course, that our type layer is selected, and we've got our type tool active. We're going to go all the way down to Dynamic Text. And notice if I click here, it can turn off the block, or we can click there, and it puts back into Dynamic. So we can go back to regular at any time. But here we've got a couple of settings. This one here is going to set the spacing between the words. So as I increase this, notice the spacing increases between words, or we can bring them down really, really tight. I think that's a little much. The other thing we can do is change the leading or the space between the lines. So if I just drag on here, notice that we can make that taller, or we can make it closer together. So we have complete control, and of course, you know, we can choose set amounts right here. Now notice, if I use the Move tool, I can scale this up and down. If I want to change the shape of the box, I need to make sure that I'm grabbing the Type tool and then clicking on the box. Now I can change the shape, notice that. And if you want this out of the way, just put it at the top and then just choose to pin that taskbar. Now right now, I'm working with paragraph text. You can also do the same thing with just regular text. If we just click and we type in some text, let's make it a little bit bigger though. Okay, so let's just change the color of that to white. Now we can make this dynamic. Click on the corner and watch this. Now we can change it. And if I want to have my name on its own line, just hit the Enter key. And hit the Enter key afterwards. And now my name is going to be its own line. So this makes it really easy to create blocks of beautiful looking text. Let me just show you, if I was to do this manually, let me just go back here. What I would have to do is I would have to go up here and I would have to resize that text. And then I would grab the one underneath. and I would resize it underneath. Doesn't seem so bad, right? But look at this. Notice that the leading is wrong. We can change the size of it. All right, so we can change the size, but notice that the spacing is not quite right. So in order to do that, I would have to grab it here, and then I would have to start to bring these a little bit closer together. And then I would have to do this line separately. And there we go. But look at that. Oh no, we've got the comma. We'd have to go and fix it. So as you can see, you know, just doing this with the dynamic text, boom, it's done. It's just so easy now. And you can see with the dynamic text, it's just instant. So if you like type as much as I do, this is a great feature. It's going to save so much time in the future, and it's going to help us create more beautiful looking typography. And also, don't forget, if you're a Creative Cloud subscriber and you have Adobe Fonts, which are included, you have 1,500 new fonts, including some of the most popular of all time from Monotype. Anyway, let me know your thoughts in the comments underneath. And if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.